does.
Deborah.
Well?
Out of the way, please. Out of the way, please.
Dirty, filthy Jew! Do it, stop!
My lord?
Thank you, James. One pepper. Thank you, ladies first. Thank you. Thank you, one pepper. Thank you.
This massive 334-page document, which does not yet disclose the final verdict, is studiously even-handed.
It is difficult to say on which side Mr. Justice Gray's decision will land.
He praises Irving's skill as a military historian, while at the same time drawing attention to flaws in some of his reasoning.
I shall read my judgment. It appears to me that the correct and inevitable inference must be that the falsification of the historical record was deliberate, and that Irving was motivated by a desire to present events in a manner consistent with his own ideological beliefs. Even if that involved distortion and manipulation of historical evidence. In the result, therefore, the defense of justification succeeds. The court finds for the defendants.
Court rise. Well done. Thank you. Muzzle top!
Brilliant, muzzle top!
You didn't let me say anything. I didn't say it then.
Well, nor did I think how I feel. It's not true. It's not true, Deborah. It was your book. Your book held up in every aspect. Every aspect, every detail. We defended it, but it was the book. It was the book.
I know. Thanks for all your hard work, Laura.
Deborah, it's like a dream job.
Well done. Well done.
This has been called one of the most crushing libel judgments in history.
The judge called Mr. Irving an anti-Semite, a racist, and a distorter of history.
So Julius, can you tell us how you're feeling at this time?
I feel terrific. This is a wonderful day. Wonderful day for everyone.
Deborah, how are you feeling about today's verdict?
Now you can speak.
Great!
Can you expand at all on that?
Come on.